Jesus, thank you, Jesus. We lift you up in praise. We lift you up in praise. We lift you up in praise. Hallelujah. 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 Thanking you today, my Lord. Thanking you today, my Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father.
In the name of Jesus, we exalt you.
Yes.
We give your name praise. And we give your name glory.
You are excellent, my Father. You are excellent, my Father.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I give you praise. I give you praise. I give you praise.
Yes, Jesus.
You're worthy.
Yes, Jesus.
Of all glory.
Yes, Jesus.
And worthy of all honor. As you that have been willing and doing to your good pleasure, oh Father God, glory be to God, we give you praise. Hallelujah. Glory be to God.
Your kingdom come. Your kingdom come. Your kingdom come.
Glory to God. Wednesday night. Bible study.
Amen. Glory
to the blessing of Abraham.
Hallelujah.
Christians in the global ministry.
Hallelujah.
We give him praise.
Yes, we
and
do.
Thank him for another
glorious day.
Amen.
Amen. To go to his word. We give him praise. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you for being here. Amen. We have 2 Timothy 4, glory to God, and verse 11, glory to God. Paul says, only Luke is with me. And remember, Luke got hooked into this company in Philippi. He's the beloved physician. Timothy had just been circumcised when Luke came with them. And Paul's back had a whole bunch of beads on his back, so they needed a doctor to go with them. In the meantime, the doctor got converted, glory to God, and ended up writing the Gospel of Luke as well as the book of Acts. So he is traveling with them, moving in ministry, moving in revelation. Glory to God. He said, only Luke is with me. He said, take Mark and bring him unto thee. Now, we might want to look and say, why did he make a note of bringing Mark? Glory to God. Remember, Mark was Barnabas' cousin or his nephew. Glory to God. And he was a little wimpy whine crybaby. So Paul sent him away. Matter of fact, that's why Paul and Barnabas got into it, was over John Mark. Paul was saying, like, hey, we on a missionary journey. This guy, he's not getting it. So, listen, we're going to have to leave him here. And Barnabas was like, no, because that's my kinfolk. I'm not leaving him here. But Paul was more focused and honed in on the ministry and the ministry that was at hand. And so they split, glory to God, Barnabas, Mark. But now, here, Mark is he's done something in between the time that they split and he sent him away until now. He said, because bring Mark. For he is profitable to me for the ministry. So obviously Mark has done some growing and he's ready now to go and be with Paul. So he said, bring it. Glory to God. You know, you might be useless today, but tomorrow, glory to God, God can find some use for you. You can't just trash people. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Because, I mean, sometimes you don't know what people basically are living through. Glory to God. And where they are mentally. Some people, of course, you can't just use them in the state that they're in, glory to God, to do ministry, glory to God, because you end up you end up, it ends up costing you more than it's worth. Taking people who are not ready to do ministry and getting them to do ministry. You know, sometimes we have to live through it because we don't have any more help. So, remember I told you the scenario? Right people doing the right thing, wrong people doing the right thing, right people doing the wrong thing. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You know, the whole thing about ministry is what it is. It's service. A minister is a servant, not some, you know, whoop-de-doo big deal. Now, it doesn't work like that. Mark wasn't ready. And then he caused contention between Barnabas and Paul. I mean, they were sharp. Boom, they split. But now, Paul is saying, bring him. He's going to be profitable. So in between that time, Mark did something to become profitable. He's talking to Timothy.
Timothy to bring Mark?
Yeah, he said bring Mark with you. Glory to God. Let's keep going. He's profitable to me for ministry. And to Caicus have I sent to Ephesus. The cloak that I left at Troas in Corpus, when thou comest, bring with thee. Don't forget the books. Did you notice he wants some books? Don't forget my books. Bring my books. But especially the parchments. Glory to God. Don't forget the books. Glory to God. Let's keep going. Alexander the coppersmith did me much evil. He said the Lord reward him according to his works. Alexander? Yeah. He said the Lord will reward him for what he's doing. You know, it doesn't make any difference what you do, you're going to get rewarded for it. You do good, you're going to get rewarded for it. You don't do good, you think people don't know? People think you don't know that you're working with the devil. Huh? Little nasty devil. Just whisper in your ear. Go do this. This is real crazy. Go ahead and do this. Not knowing the work is going to be rewarded. Glory to God. You know what you do for God? I'm happy.
Amen.
I'm happy to be doing what I'm doing. Glory to God. And then doing this with a lot of grumbling. And whatever, God will reward it. Amen. It's taking place. It's happening now. In the name of Jesus. It's taking place right now. My faith is working. I wouldn't be standing here, glory to God, if I didn't have faith in God. I wouldn't. I, man, forget that. They ain't going in, you know, up there at church. And then just go down the list. But no, faith in God. Because, listen, your work will be rewarded. Whether it's good, whether it's evil. Again, hallelujah, back in the early stages of the ministry, we taught on the four things, attitude, motive, relationships, and values. Glory to God. What's your attitude, glory to God, about the Lord's work? What is your attitude? I have to ask myself, what's my attitude? What's my attitude when I come, amen, to teach Bible study? Go on. I got to check it. Bad attitude, bring bad results. Bad motives, bad relationships, and bad values. Amen?
Amen.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. I'm really getting on this kick now. Of eating. and how you eat. And you'd be surprised what some stuff that I was putting in my body, I just speak for myself, what it's actually doing to your body and while it's in there. It's no value in it. It's nothing progressive about it. The only claim to fame is it tastes good. Glory to God. Apples taste good. Bananas taste good. Strawberries taste good. Right? So why would this other stuff? Same thing with life. You bringing this into your life. This is what this will do to you if you bring it in your life. You're bringing it in anyway. We're bringing it in anyway. People don't think that, man, I make 3 steps forward and then 20 steps backwards. I just quit. Man, I'm not listening. That's not going to get me where I need to go. It's not going to put me in the frame of mind that I need to be in. Are you hearing me? Because see, the word of God, amen, and doing and working and doing stuff with God, it's not doing stuff for God, it's doing stuff with God. Glory to God. It's all going to be rewarded. It's going to be rewarded. I've probably got in the last 2 months or so 3 prophets, prophetic words, and all of the prophetic words had to do with sacrifice. And now also studying on how the sacrifice brings faith. How sacrificing for God brings favor into your life. The sacrifice of favor. How about the prayer invoking favor? How about all of the little things that we can do that invokes the favor of God, because he has promised that this is what I'll do. This is how I'll favor you if you just do this. And it's not like a conditional thing. It's simply an obedience. If you obey it, it happens. If you don't obey it, it does not happen. Whatever I do for God, whatever I want to do for God, I want to try to do my very best at doing it. In 4 years, coming up 4 years, I can count on one hand the times I haven't been at service. I can count them. Somebody say, hey, guess what? We're going to be doing such and such on Wednesday. I won't. My schedule is already set. This is what I do. Well, on Sunday, you know, glory to God, we go do such and such and such a thing. Not me. That is locked in. That schedule. Glory to God. Amen. Maybe I take a vacation. Hallelujah. Glory to God. But my focus is building the church. Wake up. Building the church. And now I'm getting real hungry for souls to get saved. I'm talking about real hungry.
Amen.
I'm crying out to God for souls to be saved. Souls. Souls, Lord. Souls. So, because this church has the right. It has the right to go to the next level. Not because of anything we did or anything. But if he come and inspect the tree, see, he come every year to inspect you and say, hey, how'd you do? Nothing there. Then finally he said, there's nothing there on the tree. Let's cut it down. They said, wait a minute, don't cut it down. Hold on. Let's dumb the run. Let me dumb. Give me one more year. If this man, he gonna turn 12. If he's still in kindergarten this time next year, then, you know, we just leave him in kindergarten. Whoever came up with the philosophy of the education system understood, or maybe understood, because it's like that. You change from primary or kindergarten to go to first grade, then second grade, then you go on up the ladder. If you're still in the same place, 4 years, you're nine now. You're still in kindergarten. Them little chairs. Them little chairs, you'd have been outgrown them little chairs. And the only focus is I'm going to get the cookies and the milk. After I take, I'm going, what did you get me up to get me dressed to send me up here to take a nap? To take a nap, eat some cookies, maybe sing some ABC. Maybe just sing, or come on, let's sing the ABC. You nine. You should know the ABCs by heart by now. But you're still dealing with the ABCs in primary because that tree has not produced any type of fruit. Amen? And it's time to press. Lord, I must be fruit. Lord, I must multiply. I must replenish there. I must so do it. Because that's your will and that's your purpose. Glory be to God. Amen. Why be in church? Jesus said, why call me Lord and don't do what I say? Glory to God. No condemnation. But he asked, that's just a question. Why do you call me Lord? Lord, 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 Lord. And don't do what I say. Glory to God. Amen. Mm-hmm. Are y'all agree?
Amen.
He's going to reward. The Lord will reward him according to his word. Of whom be thou ware also, for he had greatly withstood our words. That's his problem. That was Alexander the coppersmith's problem. He was withstanding the word of God. Do you know from being on this broadcast line, do you know how many people, dear God, that's opposed the word? I'm serious. They opposed the word. Glory to God. You could go right. Now, Paul was talking about the power of the church today, this morning, to forgive sin. To forgive sin, to take it out. He said, y'all forgave, so I forgave for Christ's sake. He tell the church of Corinth, that's what happened. Now, Jesus put it this way. He said, whoever sins, you remit. Didn't he say that? I'll remit them. And whoever sins you retain, I'll retain. So he's telling us in the power of the church and the way he set the church up, he's giving the church authority and power, glory to God, to remit sin or retain. Now, because people have gotten so far away from the cross. I mean, we talk about the cross at Easter. That's it. You being juvenile, you out there preaching on the cross. We're going to hear about the cross every week. We do need to hear about the cross every single week, every day. Paul said, if any man glory, let him glory in the cross. By whom the world is crucified to us, and we crucified to the world. How? By the cross. So people have gotten so far away from the cross. I'm going to ask some questions, glory to God, because how many sins was put on Jesus when he went to the cross?
All
of them. So you mean Jesus was manifest to do what? To take away sin, right? So if he was manifest to take away sin, and he finished with the work that the Father sent him, he must have taken it away. So how do we walk in victory with a sin consciousness? What is a sin consciousness? When the Word of God is brought forth to you, and the only scriptures that people seem to be able to find is those who talk about sin as if sin is a problem. Don't get me wrong. We don't sin that grace may abound. God forbid that that should happen. When somebody think, well, I just go sin and then grace got me, you need to get saved. That's what I would do. Yes, get saved. Because if you saved, I'm telling you right now, that righteousness is on the inside of you, glory to God, and that righteousness will work itself out. Don't be tricked, John said. He that worketh righteousness is because he is righteous.
Amen.
That's the key. Not to do righteous, but be righteous. Because if you be righteous, you're going to do righteous. Not, it's going to be the other way around. Glory be to God. But people, you know, cry loud, glory to God, and spare not. Lift up your voice like a trumpet in Zion. Show my people they transgression. Huh? And the house of Jacob, huh? They sing. Huh? What the hand for? What happened? Okay, now, after we finish doing we're going to take you to show you your transgression. And the house of Jacob, they sing. We're going to take you. Come. Come, go with us. I'm going to show them to you. I'll take you right to Calvary. Because y'all just told me, right? It was all of them, right?
Mm-hmm.
Huh? Come on, I'm going to show you your transgression. House of Jacob, they sin. Come on. We going to a place called Golgotha, the place of the skull. We the Calvary. Glory to God, where they lifted him up between two thieves. The Bible said God laid on him the iniquity of us all. So how... if he dealt with this stuff, how do we just keep on talking about it as if it's the problem? Well, I know the problem is, it's just too much sin. Huh? How you know? I just know. How about righteousness? You would probably know who doing as much righteousness as doing sin, right? You'd probably be privy to the same amount. Jesus came to save sinners, and Paul said, I am the chief. Are y'all brief? Now, they can withstand your words, but I'm telling you, they were following Paul every place he went. Let's go with Paul. Why? Paul is over here telling these people they always triumph in Christ. Paul is over here telling these people that they're more than conquerors through him who love them. Paul is telling them that they crucified with Christ, nevertheless they live, but it's no more them. It's Christ and the life that they now live in the flesh. They live by the faith of the Son of God who loved them and gave himself for them. Paul is over here telling them that God is enriching them in all things. Whether it be utterance, whether it be knowledge, God has enriched them in all things. We got to go over here and tell these people We got to go over here and bring these people back up under this law where they can be condemned. Because, see, man, these people are free over there. You should have seen them over there. Glory to God, last Sunday, dancing around over there. Glory to God, they done got some stuff that Paul done told them, and they dancing about. Paul done told them, if God be for you, who can be against you? And them people is over there rejoicing, they happy. Glory to God, they lit up. Glory to God. That dusty look done gone off of them. They got that high pro glow light. Glory to God. Glory to God. They just shining like the noonday sun. Hallelujah. Blessed be God. Amen. Mm-hmm. We got to do something about this. This is where Alexander the prophet was. He was standing the word. Glory to God. 16. At my first answer, no man stood with me, but all men forsook me. I pray God that it may not be laid to their charge. Praying for their forgiveness. Father, forgive them. They had to go. It was a lot of pressure, man. They going to kill you, and you still going? They finna chop his head off. Oh, man, I ain't fooling with him. You going to go up with some man they finna take to the electric chair and tell him you believe the same thing he believed? They finna chop his head off for what he believed. Paul said everybody backed up off out of here. It's one by one they started pulling out. Glory to God. He said, don't lay it to their child. Forgive them. Keep going. Notwithstanding, the Lord stood with me and strengthened me.
Thank you.
That by me the preaching might be fully known, and that all Gentiles might hear. And I was delivered out of the mouth of the lion.
Yes,
well. He had to stand by himself as far as men was concerned, but the Lord went with him. He said, deliver them out of the mouth of the lion. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So this preacher might be fully known. Keep going. And the Lord shall deliver me from what?
Every evil work.
How many evil works?
Every evil work.
And I know the Lord shall deliver me, deliver you, deliver anybody who come to him from every evil work.
Right.
Now, if this goal is put here and it's not the will of God, then what? Maybe not God's will that you get delivered from. You're going to have to go talk with God about that.
Right.
Because he say, here, if he delivered Paul from every evil work, he's delivering us from every evil work. He will deliver us from every evil work. And do what else?
Preserve me into his heavenly kingdom.
To whom be glory forever.
He said he's going to deliver me from every evil work and do what else? Preserve me in his kingdom. Deliver us from every evil work and preserve us in his kingdom. To whom be glory forever and ever. Amen. That's why we give him glory. That's why we return the glory to him. Because it's him who is at work and delivering us from every evil work. He didn't say quit. He said, get delivered from it. Big difference. I quit. Okay, so what? You quit. God delivers us from every evil work, and he preserves us in his heavenly kingdom. That's why we give him glory. And the glory is done to him. Because let me tell you something. The work that God does in us is to glorify himself. Jesus said, glorify your son that your son might glorify you. Amen. So God glorifies us so that he can be glorified. Keep going. Is that it? End of the book?
No.
Salute Prisca and Aquila, and the household of Onesiphorus. The raiders are bold at Corinth, but Trump Trophimus have I left at Miletus sick. Do thy diligence to come before winter. Eublis greeted thee, and Pudin and Linus and Claudia and all the brethren. The Lord Jesus Christ be with thy spirit. Grace be with you. Amen. Huh? The Lord Jesus be with your spirit. Why? You know my mama in the Bible? I found my mama in the Bible. Watch it. Go down. That's my mama name. I found my mama in the Bible.
Amen.
Mama, are you in the Bible? I was teaching on, Paul said we didn't come preaching yay and nay. Yay and nay nay. I really did grow up with somebody named Yay Yay. That's what they call him, Yay Yay. And Nay Nay, I know I grew up with a lot of Nay Nay. So Yay Yay and Nay Nay was in the Bible. I can't wait to get to Chicago. I gotta find Yay Yay and Nay Nay. Look, I found y'all in the Bible. Here's Yay Yay right here and Nay Nay right here. Amen?
Amen.
Glory to God. The Word of God got something for everybody. Praise His holy name. Come on over before the winter, he said. Because you got my coat with you. And my books. Glory to God. Come on, bring my coat. Timothy, come before the winter. Glory to God. Okay, let's keep going. We're going to five now, right? We still in four? Oh, we in Titus. Okay. Some good stuff coming forth in Titus. Glory to God. The Lord will deliver you from how many evil works?
All.
How many people expect that?
I expect
that. How many people encounter that?
Amen.
Engage it.
Amen.
Lord, you deliver me from every evil work and preserve me into your kingdom.
Amen.
And I bring you glory and I bring you honor, Father God, because of you. Do you know you can believe for that?
Yes.
You can release your faith. You can have an encounter with the delivery from every evil work. Why don't you just lay down flat sometime on the bed and just lift your hands and just, you know, it's just quiet, it's just you and God. Oh, I know you'll deliver me from everything and preserve me in your kingdom. You'll bring me out of every piece of darkness. You'll deliver me from darkness. You'll deliver, I know you, I'm releasing my faith in me and you now. Come on and deliver me from every evil work and preserve me in your kingdom. Come on, do it. Come on, Lord, I'm believing your word right now. Glory to God, by the power of God. Amen. Hallelujah. Paul, a servant of God and an apostle of Jesus Christ, according to the faith of God's elect, and the acknowledging of the truth which is after godliness. Glory to God. He's going to talk a lot about this godliness to Titus. Glory to God. Acknowledging the truth, which is after godliness. Do you know that a great part of walking in truth is acknowledging that something is the truth? If you don't acknowledge that it's the truth, you argue. I mean, that's what an imagination is. It's an argument. Casting down arguments. Glory to God. God telling you something, and you arguing with him in your mind about what he's telling you. He said acknowledging the truth. That's what godliness is. Acknowledging the truth. If God says this is who I am, I must be who God says I am. If God says I can do this, I must be able to do it. If God says I have it, it must belong to me. You got to acknowledge the truth. That's what godliness is. Acknowledging the truth. In hope of eternal life, which God, that cannot lie, promised before the world began. So if God promised me eternal life before the world began, how much wrong did I do before the world began? How much? How much right did I do before the world began? You see, when Jacob and Esau was in Rebekah's womb, they weren't even born yet. Unless they did something wrong in the womb, which the Bible tells us they did. They didn't even know the difference. They had no chance to do evil or good. That's when God made a choice of Jacob. He was in Rebekah's womb when choice was made of him. Well, you know, Esau did wrong. Well, wait a minute. He didn't do no wrong before he got lost the choice. The choice went to Jacob. They didn't have a chance to do any kind of performance or anything else. They were just picked. Jacob was just picked by God. Chosen in the womb. That this is the one, be the one that this blessing and this lineage is going to go down through. And that's before they were born. He's saying here, God promised to do this for us before the world began. Okay? Read on. But has in due times manifested his word through preaching, which is committed unto me according to the commandment of God our Savior. To Titus, my own son, after the common faith. Everybody say common faith.
Common faith.
Well, people say, well, you got this over here, you got this over here, you got this over here, you got this over here. Wait a minute. All of this starts with one thing, and that's the Bible. Where's your interpretation of the Bible? Well, no scripture is of any private interpretation. How did you come up with another interpretation of the Bible? Common faith. You see, this is what Jude is talking about when he says that we ought to earnestly contend for the faith that was once delivered to the saints. Now, how the first century church is teaching one thing, and now we get to the 21st century church, and we got another thing that we're doing. He said, these were the instructions in the first century church. How did we fall away from the first century church to get to where we are right now? I tell you how we did. We lost the common faith. We lost the Word of God. The Word of God did not just keep on being the center of what we do. Now, you go to the Catholic Church, or you go to the Methodist Church, the podium is over here. Why is the podium off to the side? I tell you why. The Word was not the center of worship, the altar was. And so therefore the altar is in the center of where people come in the sanctuary. So they replace the Word, or the center of the Word, with the center of the altar. The pulpit is in the center because the center of worship is the Word. Now, right, wrong, I didn't have time to go through all of that kind of stuff about who's right, who's wrong, this right, this wrong. Glory to God. Just do what God says to do. That simple as that is. Glory to God. You sit down and measure this right, this wrong, this right, this wrong. Glory to God. You're always hesitating. Glory to God. Eating from the tree that Adam ate from. If you eat from the tree Adam ate from, it's going to do the same thing to you that it, to us that it did to him. That's killing.
Yes. Same result.
Common faith. Common faith. Common faith is an individual thing that comes in a corporate way. Because you as an individual can take faith in God and change your life. You see, the church is about change people. It's not about what building we go to and who there, who not there. It's a relationship with God. I can believe God with you, but there are certain things that come in your life that my faith is not going to do anything. It's going to take yours. Your faith in God. Wait, let's go. No. Being in church don't make you a Christian any more than being in a garage make you a car. You just go stand up out there in the garage. I'm a car. No. I've been hanging out with the cars, so I must be a car. No. Glory to God. It's your faith. It's your faith. Without faith, it's impossible to please God. He, talking about the individual that come to God, must believe that he is. He has dealt to every man the measure of faith, and that faith is common. Let me tell you something, it'll work for anybody. Glory to God. Amen. It'll work for Lil Eastman. Lil Eastman can stand right up now and say, God said this and I believe it, and I guarantee you it's going to happen for him.
Amen.
Man, I've seen this work better with little children than with adults. Them children say, hey, wait a minute. I seen one time. Glory to God. We was getting ready for a big function. Amen. At the church. And I had a pastor before. Yep. We was getting ready for a big function. So everybody gathered up together. And the reason why we gathered up together, because we were cleaning up all around, sweeping up, make sure everything was done and looked really nice before this big function at the church. All of a sudden, this cloud comes in. You feel a couple drops of rain. Everybody's outside working. And you feel a couple drops of rain. Then you feel them, they're getting a little bit heavier in the rain. So it's raining, gonna mess up the cleanup crew. I seen a four-year-old boy jump off the church stairs. I'm talking about just jump off the church stairs. It's starting to rain. Jump off the church stairs. And he said, Elijah was a man of like passion just like me. And he commanded the rain to stop, and it stopped. And I'm commanding the rain to stop today, and it must stop in Jesus' name. Boom. Rain stopped. Everybody looking at the little four-year-old. Well, he done been to Bible study, glory to God, and they've been teaching on Elijah.
Amen.
And he said, Elijah stopped rain, he gonna stop rain.
Amen.
Today, he gonna stop rain. Do you see, glory to God, the children come here in the world. The younger they are, the closer they are to where they came from. And the more where they came from makes sense to them before grown people talk them out of it. Now you know you. They're not afraid. I mean it. Boy, if you don't get down off them up on the top of that wall about to jump down, he's not scared. They're not scared. Oh, my God. Yeah, oh, my God. And then you done made them nervous. You done start making the child nervous. Wait a minute. You, I got to produce. Here, come here. I need to produce a child of doubt now. Wow. You're going to have to get away from this common faith thing that you operate in. You believe you can do anything. You believe you can be anybody. You believe My God, you sit on there and you see Spider-Man, you think you Spider-Man. You don't want to get mama towels and stuff tied all up around your neck. You Spider-Man now. Why? Because you saw it and you believe that that's what you could become. Glory to God. Do you see that? So, I mean, I just have, glory to God, respect for Sister Eastman, because Sister Eastman say, hey, listen, I'm going to take him where he can get into the Word. Amen. And, you know, hey, come in. Tell them what scripture you learn. And little Eastman just run the scriptures off. Yes. He's learning the Word of God. Amen. Getting grounded and rooted in the Word of God. Not being talked out of it. You see, that's what Alexander the Coppersmith's problem was. He withstood the Word. This common faith. You see, faith come by hearing. And hearing by the Word of God. You listen to something, and that's what you're going to become. If somebody tell you dumb, stupid, and no good, glory to God, you just keep on listening to them, you dummy. Yes. You, guess what? You'll start behaving like that. Somebody tell you, you know, you got the wisdom of God. Christ has made unto you wisdom and righteousness and sanctification and redemption. You start believing that. Glory to God. You start believing that by the stripes of Jesus I'm healed. You right. Just keep on hearing that. You just keep on hearing it. And you keep on hearing that. That's like common faith. Glory to God. That faith in man, if I heard the Word, my God, and I believe the Word. I see it. I believe it. Guess what? I'm becoming it. In the name of Jesus. That common faith. The common faith. Not only common faith, but grace and mercy
and peace
from God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ, our Savior. Glory to God. Hallelujah. For this cause, left I thee in Crete. I left you over there, Titus. And here's why I left you. That thou shouldest set in order things that are wanting. Because I know you dealing with this common faith, and what's lacking, you're going to start putting it down. And you're going to do it by God's grace and by God's mercy, and you're going to do it through the Lord Jesus Christ. That's why I left you over there in Crete. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And ordain elders in every city as I had appointed thee. Keep going. If any be blamed, the husband of one wife, having faithful children, not accused of riot or being unruly. Glory to God. For a bishop must be what?
Blameless. The husband of one wife, having faithful children, not accused.
Huh? The bishop must be what?
Blameless. As a steward of myself.
You mean to tell me a bishop must be blameless? He must be blameless as the steward of God. Stewardship. He must be a steward. A good. That's a bishop now. He must be. Stewardship is for church people too. Did you know that? A steward. Do you have people in it? I'm going to get a Bible college. I'm telling you, before this thing is over, hallelujah, God's going to give us a Bible college. Amen. And when people come to Bible college, you'll have a whole course on stewardship.
Amen.
A whole course on justification. A whole case on glorification. A whole course on sanctification. And if people walk around like you know, how do you know? Nobody never taught you. You didn't learn it yourself, but you know. That's pride. That's really what it is. It's pride. Huh? You ever done that? No. You ever read that? No. What does the Bible say about it?
I don't know what the Bible says about it. Glory to God, who we even think about what the Bible says about it? We just gonna do this thing because I'm smart.
You not. God don't do things the way the world do things. Are you here? Some of the principles that you learn in the Word does work. Trust me, they do. But having stewardship with God, it's like a totally, it's like a totally different thing. If you build a life with God, you're not gonna build your life the same way the world build it.
Right.
Right. Are you hearing me? Amen. You can't say I'm representing the Christian right and lying. They're lying, hey. But that's the Christian right, though. What were you lying for? Tell the truth. I ain't saying nothing. You're wrong about something. Amen. You can just be wrong. That don't mean you're lying. But if you know you just outright lying, glory to God. A lie is just a lie. Glory to God. He said, blameless as a steward of God, not self-will. You know, just interested in self. What about me? What about me?
Nah.
Self-will. Not soon angry. This just fly, not angry, not self-will, not soon angry, not given to wine. You know wine? Y'all know what wine is, right? Huh? Anybody here know what wine is? Just wine. Let's go get a bottle. Let's get tightened up. I imagine Christians in Chicago drink, but they don't drink out in the open like saints do here. Saints in here, they drink out in the open. They'll be out there in the parking lot drinking. Bring some wine in here. Let's have a little taste. Huh?
So what
do you say to that? The saints all over it. Wait a minute, hold on, y'all. This church. Now wait a minute. Come on, over the lips, over the gum. Look out, tummy here, come. No wine for the vision. No striker, not giving the filthy lucre. Glory to God. Not for sale. Glory to God. Kind of like John the Baptist. You couldn't offer. What could you offer John the Baptist? He was eating grasshoppers.
And locusts and honey.
And honey. And his clothes was just a little camel hair and a belt. Right? John was out there. Glory to God. What could you go out there and offer John? John looked up at the people and said, man, this generation of vipers, who warned you to come out here? Who warned you to flee the wrath that's coming on you? John wasn't all caught up in and hooked up in that. Glory to God. Do you know what? Prosperity is a part of the gospel. Matter of fact, the gospel is the blessing. But if you can't wait on prosperity, you make some of the moves for prosperity, my God. It's not good. You didn't bust a move. Now you got out the will of God. Hallelujah. Just to get your prosperity before God gave it to you. Before it manifested. Here you go. Glory to God. Yeah, when you get out there in the world, my God, you in church, you don't be known as a person on your job as a person that don't have no integrity. No character. You dip, tip, jive, connive, do all this other stuff. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Man, I had to go in to my supervisor a few times and repent. You know why? Because I was out of order.
Well, that's just a heathen supervisor. So what? When you're going in there for them 8 hours, that heathen supervisor is put there on you back up. And they're trying to work something out in you. Glory to God. I mean, really, I said, man, let me tell you something. I'm going to let you know something right now. What? You treat me like that. You talk to me like that. I'm telling you right now, you'll have to kill me before I let you treat me like less than a man. I was hot. Soon angry. Soon angry, self-will, all of that stuff. I had to go back and I had to apologize. Listen, I had no right. Well, you really didn't have no right to talk to me like that. I didn't tell him that. But I had no right to respond or react to you the way that I reacted. I misrepresented the kingdom of God. I misrepresented my Lord Jesus Christ. And I misrepresented your authority. Because the only way you can have authority is you learn how to be in under authority.
Amen.
And God keep coming and hunting. He kept on coming and hunting for that thing. I had one. My God. She was evil. When I say evil, I mean evil. I'm talking about Bible evil. She had two problems. She didn't like black people, and she didn't like me. I was both. It got me, man, a double whammy up in here. My God, she did everything but slap me in my face. And guess what I learned to do? Go to the little dollar store. You know the dollar store have them little bags in there, the pretty ones. You can just go get one with the string on the top. And you could buy some pretty paper, and you could buy some little trinkets and put in there. And I used to just buy her gifts and buy her a card. Every time she did something evil to me, I'd go buy her a gift and bring it to her, all wrap it up real pretty. That didn't make her no better. Evil, that's evil. I made myself pay, though, for letting her get under my skin. I let it cost me something. Every time I would let her get under my skin. And you know, pastoring, you better have this stuff. You can't, man, you be in a dip. I mean, like, hey, Brother Marvin, Lord be God. What's up, Brother Marvin? You here? How was your ride to work today? Glory to God. Hallelujah. Brother Marvin, you think, man, you think maybe I could figure out a way to get me a roll in an Oreo? Yes, but them Oreos, I'm telling you that the Oreos is big money. That's big money. You got some Oreos, let somebody send you a big pack of Oreos. You can, for at least a month.
Glory to God.
But you can't get caught up in that kind of stuff. The devil come. Jesus said it this way. He said, I got to stop. Sister Mitchell, I got to stop. Jesus said it this way. He said, you're not going to hear me talking that much anymore. He said, because that wicked one comes and he finds nothing in me. You got to be real honest about this stuff. That wicked one don't come in. Catch stuff inside you that he can latch on to.
Right.
Because he's going to keep coming right on in there and latching on to it. Oh, I'm going to ring your bell. Ring my bell. Glory to God. He's coming right in there and latch on to it. Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you that we finished with 1 Timothy and 2 Timothy, Father, and we started over in Titus. Glory to God, it's starting to get good. Father God, it's getting better and better and better. We give you praise for it. We encounter, Father God, not being self-willed, not being soon angry, nor giving the wine a striker, nor giving over the filthy lucre, Father. We thank you for these instructions, Father God, that you've given to us.